Hi everyone. Until now we have covered the basic building blocks for manual part of the SOAPO testing. And now let's get into automation part using Groovy. And what we are going to cover in this is like basically the three objects, context object and test runner and log object, which is usually the basic building blocks for the Groovy scripts. And then followed by we'll see how to execute a multiple SOAP requests from a single Groovy script, and then we'll see how to add properties, how to set the properties and get the properties at the global level and various levels as I specified at the project level, test suite level, and the test case level. And then we will continue with the property transfer concept, as you have seen, how we can do the property transfer using manual work through the UI. Similarly, we'll see how to do the property transfer using Groovy script. And other than that, we'll see how to handle data-driven part. So let's get into the automation part. So let's start. Let's begin. So basically, we already created a sample project for the day one, where we had done the basic tests. Now what we are going to do is just mock those things. Just we are going to copy, we are just going to clone those things. So this is the basic test we had created while we are working with manual part. So we'll just copy it. We'll clone the project. Cannot clone the project, we can just clone the source. Okay, we'll just create one more empty project. So in here we'll be learning the basics of Groovy scripting. So we'll just make sure name is basic Groovy. And target to hit. So this is all we have. So what we have done in the manual part? Let's run this to script. Let's change this UI. Just see. Simulated and verify the response 30. So this is the basic thing which we had seen there. Now we'll be adding the Groovy script as a test tip. And you can see in here, script is invoked with log, context, and test runner variables. So basically, we can see that we are having three basic objects to work with Groovy. Now add other steps. For multiplication, division, and subtraction. So assume like for multiply also, I want to add one more step. And then, okay, set up the operation. Go for all the solutions. Click OK. Now give some value. Let's say I will be giving 10 and 2. And simulate it, and the results will be 20. Okay, so this is manually you're running each and every request like this. So now I want you to run all these requests at one shot from using Groovy. So let's do it. For this, what we need to do is we need to use the test runner option. So test runner dot. Now we are at test case level, sorry, test step level. From test step level to test case level we need to go, because under the test case only we are having multiple test steps which we need to run. So test case dot test steps. So in here we need to mention one thing. The first one will be the lowercase and next will be uppercase. This needs to be followed, and then square brackets in double quotations, give the name of test step. Okay, and store this into some other variable. Now runner dot run off. Test runner, comma, context. It says that we want you to run. You have navigated to this path. This step, test step, add test step, and then you wanted to run. You wanted to run this test step. Just let us click. Just let me check log dot info box on this. Not pretty much sure whether log out info works or not. Just let me check it out. So just let's click one more time. So you can see it gets highlighted and it goes out into green. So what it says, if you don't have any errors, it will show like this. All the assistants got passed. Now I want you to run multiple test steps at one shot. Similarly, now I want you to run multiply also. let me just change it, and the name of this is Spotify. Test runner again, text runner. Let's execute again. So it's executed successfully. And you can see the results. Okay. So we have a doubt whether it's really getting executed or not. So 20 and Q3. Now come to Google Sheet, run again. You can see this. No? So now the response is 30. Response is 40. Let's try some more thing. Now let's try the non.info. Of something like this. Let me have a quick check whether this works. I just wanted to log the results. It doesn't seem to work. So what we can do is like we can store that response in XML folder and we can get the value from the XML folder. So let's do that part. So we have completed this part, and then we have done the navigation also. This we have seen manually auto setting. We have seen the assertions earlier, the manual part. we need to import something, class file for this XML folder. How it exists to be, let me get it from here. Available here. Let me get it. Yes. So this is the one which we need to get it. So it is import com.avware.soapy.soapy.xml folder. And so when we run the request, we'll get the response. That response will be expanded context dot expand I assume this needs to be stored. So what we are going to expand, we need to go to the path of what we are trying to expand. It's basically like this. So the particular test step followed by the response. So the test step name is add, and followed by what we are going to get add is a response. Okay, so response, then let me just go here, let's call this as a response. Okay, so just scroll it. Is add response. Okay, got this, and then we will store this in XML folder. We are expanded that XML, and we are storing the expanded XML into an XML folder. So now get this value. Get the value. I mean, now the XML holder holds all the tags. Now we want you to get holder value. So let's get node value. Sorry. So get node value of that particular node. So what is the particular node? Get node value. And then we need to give it in X part of the node. And we already taken the X part of the node. Let's get it again. So this is and store it. Let's try to log use the log object for this. Let's try. Oh, there are so many errors. Let's see what are the errors. says it should not use hash. So let's see what we are seeing in there. We should not put hash before the test step name. Test step followed by the response. Okay, let's try it again. There is something wrong. I think we need to give it in single quotes. That's what it is expecting, yeah. It's done. Perfect. The value is 40. Let's see the hash response. It's 40. So now, similarly, come back and lock the response value for multiply. Multiply response, and in here it's n is multiply. Multiply. And get it to XML holder. Then once you get it, multiply XML holder, and then you need to get the node value and then get it. The tag is same. The tag add result is same in add and multiply response. Okay, it's multiply result, sorry. Let's submit it. Something gone wrong. Not multiply. Let's go and see one more time. Is it all there? And then what's the problem? Extending the context for multiply. Multiply response and then we are storing that in multiply response. and then we are getting the node value. No, sorry. Just the recent was not getting. Okay. So let's execute it once again. So what is enter the algorithm? Let's go manually. Listen. 40 and 30. So throw a blue screen. You have done it. Okay. Now, let's do some more. So, manually inputting the values over there, let's just use the properties. Concept of properties to input the values. So, let's do that. So we are setting the property. Context.check property of key value pairs. What is the key? Key is int a. Okay. And value is 30. Okay. And then int b value is 20. Okay. Now we are setting the properties like this. Okay. So what will happen? Let me see. Instead of 20, I need to place $ x int a. Int a, and similarly $ as int b. Now let's go to Chrome script, try it once more. So let me clear it and run it one more time. So 50, that was 20, 30 into 20. So this is all. Now just let navigate and see. So what we are doing is, in this context level, we are setting the property for int a and int b. Okay. So now, how to set at a global level? For setting the property at a global level, we need to use form dot every here dot so qi dot so qi dot we might run into mistakes. Just let me copy it. So we have seen how to set the property and utilize it in the test scripts. This is code, and yeah, this is what we are going to do it. So how to set at the global level. So I'm setting the value of int a to 5. Okay. So what had happened? So let me do one more thing. Let me remove this. Let me remove this. Okay. And now, before that, let's go and see what's the value that's available at the global property. So, at the global property, value is set to 5. Now, let's simulate it. When we set at the context level overrides the global level. Int A and int B. So int A is 5. A is 5 and B multiplying. So what is the B value? 20. So 25 is 100, correct? 20 plus 5 is 25. Yeah, that's fine. So let me just do one more. So we have seen how to set the property at the global level, then the property value, and if you wanted to set the property value even at the test case level or the script level or project level, we can do it. Let's just see how to do it. Just me just do a trial and error and see if it works. Test runner dot test case dot set property value. A comma 10. Let me just check it out. So, okay. We have checked value to 10. So this is how we set the value at the test case level if you want to set it to the project level, and then we can do that. Test case dot, let's see first how to put it at the test root level. And then we can see how to do it at project level. So let me put 20 over here, the suit level, and 30 at this project level. Okay. So let's go and verify to the values available at various levels. 10, 20. And when we go to project level, it should be 30. Yes, this is correct. Now let me use as, and then let's put hash over here, and then let's execute. Something gone wrong. What actually is happening is, like, when you are doing like this, it is navigating to the test level. If you have like this, I think it works fine. It should work fine. And this comment context level. So we are having the value of a and value of b. This is a context level, and this is a test case level. There is something wrong with this. Let me just go back. Input string is not incorrect. Even if we have Australian check also, it doesn't seem to work. So my pen is being mistakes or anything. I just need to check it all. Okay. Okay. Let's make the value of B as something. I code it. Let's just check. Something strange. It looks really so strange. Okay. Since it is not global, that's the reason it didn't work. Let's see this later point of time. So we are seeing how to get the response from the tag element value from the response and display it on the log. And also we have seen how to navigate through different test steps in the test case and run different, multiple test steps at a one shot of time. And also we are seeing how to set properties at various levels. So let me try one more. trial and error. Let's just check it. So we will look at it a bit later. That's all for now.